ओके तो हम लोगों ने इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिड फॉर्मुलेशन फॉर द स्टार टू डेल्टा एंड डेल्टा टू स्टार ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड फ्रॉम दोज फिगर देन इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंसेस एंड देन फाइनली वी वेयर इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ राइटिंग सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग बैक अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट दोज डेरिवेशन बिकॉज आई हैड ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू हाउ विल यू रीच टू हाउ विल यू फाइंड आर वन आर टू आर थ्री And then I had written the expression of RP, RQ and RR. But I did not tell you that how will you reach to that. So just to explain that, I'm going back a little bit. So, agar aapko dhyan ho, so once we were writing between R, A, B. So we had taken R1, R2, R3. So of course, the first equation was R1 plus R2. And we had taken RP, RQ and RR, right? Equation dikhai ga, diagram dikhai ga. Okay, RP, RQ, RR, so between the RP, RQ and RR, the equivalent resistance was, if it is RP, RQ and RR, A and B, so RP plus RQ, so here it was RR, RP plus RQ over RP plus RQ plus RR. Is it okay? Yahi to tha. This one was the equation number one. So this is equation number one. Now the second equation that was between B and C. So if I will go by the diagram R1, R2 and R3, right? So agar hum B and C ke beech mein jayenge, then the equation is R2 plus R3. The star equivalent resistance between the terminal B and C, between the B and C was R2 plus R3, and this equivalent resistance between the RP, RQ and RR, so we were B, and ye diagram we draw kar lete hain. So this one was A, this one was B, this one was C. This one was RP, this is RQ, this one is RR. So between the B and C, what will happen? RR and RP and then RQ. So RQ, RP plus RR divided by the same sum of all. So RP plus RQ plus RR. This one was equation number two. And then further we came for RCA and now the third equation can be written on the behalf of looking over this R1 R2 aa gaya R2 R3 aa gaya so here it will be R3 plus R1 aur yahan pe dekho RR aa chuka hai RQ aa chuka hai so this is now RP and rest two that is RQ plus RR over RP plus RQ plus RR So this one was equation number three. So now further moving, I had told you that to obtain R1 minus R2, we will make equation number three minus equation number two. So we did equation number three minus equation number two. And to reach to the R1, we did plus equation number one. So from this portion we were receiving R1 minus R2 and on the left hand side and from the equation number one on the left hand side we have R1 plus R2. So finally we made sum and once we will make it sum then R2 R2 will get cancelled and finally we will have two R1 and the same process we will follow on the right hand side as well. So when on the right hand side when we will make equation number 3 minus equation number 2, then since RP plus RQ plus RR is in the denominator, so the same denominator will get followed and finally we will have RP RQ plus RP RR minus RP RQ minus RQ RR. So RP RQ will get cancelled. And we will have RP RR minus RQRR. Perfect? From 3 minus 2. And then we will make it plus this one as well. So when once we will make it plus this, so we will have RR into RP plus RR into RQ divided by RP plus RQ plus RR. So finally, this minus sign will take some. So this is RQRR, this is RQRR. So finally, we will have 2 times RPRR. RPRR divided by RP plus RQ plus RR. And that is 2 times of R1. So 2 will get cancelled. And the final expression where we are reaching is that is R1 equals to RPRR divided by RP plus RQ plus RR. So this one is the first expression which we are obtaining from these equations. There are a lot of interesting things which will come further once we are moving ahead with numericals. But you just focus on this. Why I am doing this again? Because this is very important. This derivation comes in exam, and that very valuable. 10 marks, bahut jyada hote hain. So therefore, I am just repeating this one. So now, next target is to find this R2. So to obtain R2, if I have R2 plus R3, and if somehow I can arrange R2 minus R3, right? देखिए एक तरीका तो यही है कि I have already R1. I can shift this R1 on the side, that side, and directly I will obtain. So let's do this. तो हम लोग ऐसा करते हैं, इसी को कर लेते हैं. So this is RP plus RQ upon RP plus RQ plus RR minus R1, and this R1 is RPRR upon RP plus RQ plus RR. So since we have the same denominator, so let's expand that. So it will become RP plus RQ plus RR, and this one will become RPRR into RPRR into RP will get cancelled. So finally we will have RR into RQ into RR. So this is your equation number 2. And once R2 is well known, I can find this R3 from equation number 2.
Yes.
So from equation number 2, yahan pe likh sakte hain from equation number 1. Now here from equation number 2. So from equation number 2, this R3 will become RQ RP plus RR divided by RP plus RQ plus RR and minus R2. R2 is RQ RR over RP plus RQ plus RR. Alright? So now in the denominator, RP plus RQ plus RR, and this will become RQ RPRQ. RQRR will get cancelled. Finally, we will have RP into RQ. So this is your R3. So this one is the third. This one is the second desired expression. So finally, we reach to this one. And yesterday, I had written those expressions directly. I think you are well aware of, and I believe that is also correct. So make sure. Now the next task is, once we obtained this R1, R2, R3, the next task is to find out RP, RQ and RR in terms of R1, R2, R3. So that if the values of R1, R2, R3 is given, we can obtain the value of RP, RQ, RR. So we can make both side transformation. If delta is given, star can be obtained. If a star is given, delta can be obtained. So to do so, hum log kya karenge? We have a very simple one. we will make this expression of R1, R2, R3, and we will take ratio 1 in cyclic order. Cyclic order means we will find R1 over R2, we will find R2 over R3, and then we will find R3 over R1. R3 over R1. So these ratios we will find to obtain this RP, RQ, RR. So if we will take the ratio of R1 over R2, R1 over R2, so of course denominator will get cancelled, RP plus RQ plus RR will get cancelled itself, and the rest of the expression will be RP over RR over RQ over RR. So RRR will get cancelled. So finally we will have RP over RQ. RP over RQ. And similarly, when we will make R2 over R3, so it will be RQ, RR over RP. RR over RP. Look very carefully, because sometimes I do mistake, as all you know. So please look very carefully. If there is anything wrong, please note it down immediately. Report it immediately. And then finally we will reach to R3 over R1. So R3 over R1 means what? These two expressions. RP plus RQ plus RR will get cancelled. Finally we will have R3. R3 means RP will get cancelled. RQ over RR. RQ over RR. Now the aim is to obtain RP. Our aim kya hai? We wish to have RP. So, hum log kya karenge? To find this RP, let's take this equation. And we will write here R1 equals to. Now aim, listen very carefully, this is very crucial step here. I will write, since I am looking for RP, so I will keep RP over here and rest RR and RQ I will convert in terms of RP. Clear? Yes. So what would be the advantage? In whole of the equation we will have only RP, and finally we will obtain the value of RP. Right? So we will see. So R1 equals to RP, so we will not disturb this RP because we are looking for RP into RR. And now I wish to write RR in terms of RP. So which equation will help us to write this RR in terms of RP? Of course this equation. So RR can be replaced as R2 by R3 into RP. So R2 by R3 into RP. Now similar step we'll take in the denominator as well. So therefore we will keep RP as it is, then plus RQ. Now I wish to write RQ in terms of RP. So RQ in terms of RP, of course this equation will help. So RQ will become equals to R2 over R1 into RP. R2 over R1 into RP. And then finally RR, which we have already done. Of course in the numerator, we had already written RR. So this RR will be replaced by the same expression. So therefore R2 by R3 into RP. Clear? So now the result is, in the numerator we have RP square now. While in the denominator we will take RP common from each of the terms. And then therefore we will have RP square into R2 by R3 upon, once we will take this RP as a common, then we will have 1 plus R2 over R1 plus R2 by R3. Alright? So this RP will cancel this RP. Yes. Square will get cancelled. And finally we will have, before going ahead, let's simplify this expression as well. So we can take R1, R3 as LCM in the numerator, yes. Sorry, in the denominator. In the denominator we will have R1, R3 as what we will do, we will take this R1, R3 as a LCM in the denominator. So therefore, here it will become R1, R3, and it will result into R1, R3 plus R2, R3 plus R2, R1. All right. And in the numerator, it will be R2 by R3. So this R3 will cancel this R3. And since here on this side, this there is R1, or RP bhi hoga na yahan pe. So to obtain RP, we will cross multiply karenge. But ye jante hi ho ki jab ye A by B over C by D, so isko yahan bhejte hain, isko yahan bhej dete hain. So AD over BC. So let's do the same, because otherwise it will make up many things. So it will go up and will come down one. So finally we will have this expression of RP into R2 into R1 upon R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R1, and this is equals to R1. And of course this R1 will make, this R1 cancels, so it will be 1. So therefore RP will become equals to, this will come over here and this R2 will in denominator, in denominator. So finally we will have expression of RP, and that is equals to R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R1 over R2. So this one is the expression I think I had wrote yesterday. Samajh mein aapko? And similarly I am looking for RQ as well. So now since RP is already known, so there is no need to go further in so much detail, since RP, we will keep the value of RP here and we will obtain RQ. So RQ will be what? RQ will be equals to R2 over R1 into RP. We will keep RP here, and so once we will keep RP here, so this will come R2, R2 will get cancelled, and in place of R2 there will be R1. So finally we will have a question of R1, R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R1 upon R1. And similarly we can write RR as well. So to write RR, I can put this RP or RQ anywhere. So let's keep RP. So RR will become equals to RP into R2 by R3. RR will become equals to R2 by R3 into RP. So once we will keep RP here, then this R2 will get cancelled and R2 will be replaced by R3. So this expression will become equals to R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R1 divided by R3. So this is final derivation. Okay. Now there is a very important interrelation. There is no need to memorize all these formulas. There is a strong, a very good relationship between these two. So let me tell you that one. So, but these steps are very important if derivation comes and you have to do that. Now suppose I have a delta connected RP, RQ and RR between the terminals A, B and C, and I wish to convert this delta into star. So what will I do? I will replace this delta by star, and this star will have R1, R2 and R3 values. Now suppose, of course, if the delta is given and I am looking for R1, R2, R3, so this R1 will be what? R1, the method is you just multiply the resistances on the sides. So these resistances are RP and RR divided by the sum of all three, that is RP plus RQ plus RR. So this one is your R1. Similarly, you can write down R2. R2 is this one. So the side resistances are RP and RQ. RP and RQ divided by RP plus RQ plus RR. And last, R3 also. So this R3 will be RQ and RR. RQ and RR divided by RP plus RQ plus RR. That's all. And now suppose this delta star was given and we were converting into delta. Right? So basically it means we are looking for the values of RP, RQ and RR. So the method is, if this one is given and we are looking for this one, suppose we are looking for this one. So the method is, you just cyclic keep cyclic product and product sum, like R1, R2, R1, R2, R2, R3, R3, R1. या फिर R1, R3, R3, R2, R2, R1 कैसे भी कर सकते हैं. So we'll write down R1, R2 plus R2, R3 plus R3, R1 divided by, if we are looking for this RP, the front resistance is R3. So we will keep here. And similar steps should be taken for further. So suppose if you are looking for RQ, so the front resistance is R1. And if you are looking for RR, then resistance is R2. So this is overall, overall story behind this. And it will help you a lot in solving the equivalent resistances, and sometimes sometimes current problem, voltage problem, all this will be solved through using this one. Samajh mein aa gaya aapko? So let's solve a simple numerical. Let's take that numerical which I had given you with a star delta connection, which where we could not find the equivalent resistance, and finally we had applied KVL. So let's take that example. Rest of the values I missed. So most आपने कहीं लिखा होगा जरूर, है किसी की कॉपी में? Please provide. All right. ट्वेंटी ओम, थर्टी ओम. This is 45 ohm, 10 ohm, and this one is 100 volt. Basically, we wanted to have equivalent resistance, and then we used to have find current and all this. Okay, the basic focus in this question using a star to delta and delta to star transformation is simply to find the equivalent resistance. So the problem is we are not able to find this equivalent resistance because we were not able to decide whether the series or parallel case here, because the current was getting divided but not meeting once again at the same point. So therefore we could not say that which one is in parallel. So therefore I told you that if this kind of the problem is there, it means there is somewhere delta or star is coming into the picture. अच्छा, delta तो बहुत clarity के साथ दिख रहा है हमें, star भी है क्या? कहाँ पे स्टार? इस पॉइंट पे ये तीन रेजिस्टेंसेस आपके स्टार में है भाई. इफ द थ्री रेजिस्टेंसेस आर कनेक्टेड टू द सेम पॉइंट इट मींस दे आर इन स्टार. सो दिस एट दिस पॉइंट थ्री दीज आर स्टार एंड दीज थ्री आर ऑल्सो इन स्टार. बट आई एम नॉट गोइंग फॉर स्टार टू डेल्टा कन्वर्जन, आई एम गोइंग फॉर डेल्टा टू स्टार बिकॉज इट विल सिंपली गिव अस अ सिंपल सॉल्यूशन. सो देयरफॉर so this one is now r1 and this is your r2 and this one is r3. So what would be the value of r1? 30 into 20 over sum of all three. So 30 plus 20 plus 20 50 100 600 over 100, that is equals to 6 ohm. So r1 is 6 ohm. What about r2? 20 into 50 divided by 100, 10 ohm. And then finally R3, it will be 30 into 50 divided by 100, so it is now 15 ohm. So what we will do, we will replace this delta by a simple star. So of course we will remove these existing, and that existing had been replaced by a star connected network. So that now this is 6 ohm, this one is 10 ohm and this one is 15 ohm. So now for the equivalent, now this 10 plus 50 60 in parallel 30 plus 6 plus 10. So the equivalent resistance R will become equals to 60, 10, 40, 46 ohm. समझ में आ गया सब लोगों को? All right. So 46 ohm है, इसका मतलब यहाँ पे जो करंट होगी I, that will become equals to 100 upon 46, 2.46 to the 92. तो इसका मतलब ये हो गया 8 pending है. डेसिमल जाएगा, जीरो आएगा, 80 होगा, टू टाइम्स नहीं जाएगा, वन टाइम जाएगा. 80 माइनस 46 रिजल्ट वुड बी 34. डेसिमल की वजह से फिर से जीरो जाएगा, 340 में हाउ मेनी टाइम्स? फाइव टाइम्स. सो अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 2.15 एम्पियर. आपने उस टाइम जो वही, सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन द करंट वेयर गिवन एट दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस करंट वॉज टू बी, the objective of the question was to find this current. So this is another, this is the method. समझ में आ गया सब लोगों को? So there is nothing, ऐसा कुछ नहीं कि there is something very complex or something very twisty so that it is difficult to solve. If you know the method, if you have gone through the methods, if you know all these things, we will be able to find voltage, current anywhere in the circuit. समझ में आ गया आपको?